apostle have served in such a way where people are trying to recognize if God didn't really do something new in his life, it's always going to be the way it is. Hit your neighbor and say, God getting ready to do something new. He's getting ready to do something new. The Bible says, now Nehemiah was the cupbearer at the king of Persia. He served the king. And not only was the servant of the king, but he was advisor to the king. I want to give some of you advice. If God bring you here for 7 years, and the same God who began the good work in you, he's able to finish it. God don't start stuff and don't finish stuff. No, baby. If God start things, he's able to finish it. So God says, Nehemiah, I see the condition that Nassau, Bahamas is in. And now I'm about to rise you up from serving the king. Oh, there's always a change. And anytime God brings change in your life, people will try to keep you down and tell you will always be where you're at. But the Lord sent me in this church to tell about telling you all in here, I've already changed your season. Oh my God, I'm in the wrong church. Hit your neighbor, high five. I say, neighbor, the Lord have already changed my life. God said, I'm going to take you from a cupbearer to be a governor. The Lord said, when you get to church, tell my apostle, I already made him a governor. Not just here in the Bahamas, but globally. See the problem with us in the Bahamas. Church people, it's already at. But I came to tell you in this house, I came to tell the Lord's house, that something is getting ready to hit this house. And I'm so happy that there are some people who say, it's looking like we can't get nowhere. But the Bible says in Nehemiah chapter 2, the Lord said, Nehemiah sat down and he wept over the condition that when he heard Jerusalem was going through. The Bible said, God said to Nehemiah, I'm getting ready to rise you up. Hit your neighbor on the shoulder and say, neighbor, God getting ready to rise you up. Oh, I love what I love about God. God will rise you up in the midst of your haters. Oh, you got haters everywhere. They're watching every move you make. They're watching everything you do. Because what really happened down there on Market Street to Fleming Street? God said, what I had to do, I had to do what I did. I put a fire in the midst of you just to show you I'm getting ready to put you in your own building. So you're going to have to shine. God will put some things in your life. And something to overcome. Hit your neighbor, high five. Watch when it takes to sit down and talk to you all. The Bible said Nehemiah sat down and he wept over the condition. And the Lord says to Nehemiah, touch their hands, anoint their hands, that they may do the good work. The Lord said, tell apostle, for the rest of this year, anoint your people's hands. Lord, anoint their hands, that they may do the good work. See, you got every pastor on this island. Who do you think for you? Praying for you. When they heard what happened to Fleming Street, they said, man, he finished. They shut down. But God will make a way out of no way. Is there anybody here that God can do a work? That's what never said. It's a quick work. The Lord sent me in this church to tell you all in this house, powerhouse, get ready. The power of God starts. The rain may come. Nehemiah in chapter 2. Nehemiah prayed to the Lord. He said, God, how it could be so that the people are laughing at what I am doing. God said, Nehemiah, I'm about to send you help. The Lord tell me to tell you, Apostle, he's about to send you help. Some people look at numbers. Did you remember the story? When God tell Gideon, he said, the 232,000 men, we gotta go to a place. I tell you, realize, take them down to the sea. And find out who's the man and who's the boys. There's some people, they ain't ready for battle. You want to know who's ready for battle? The man you get into a storm in your life. You will find out if you're on the side of the portal. Chapter 2. And the Lord said, Nehemiah, I'm getting ready to show forth my favor. Then God get ready to favor you. Everybody around you start hating on you. Thank God that God would allow the building in the Fleming Street would have caused them to stop from going where they're going. So they say, not this year. He ain't gonna have no pastoral anniversary. He ain't gonna have no celebration. But God will always have a way of showing up the right time. So God say, every now and then, I'll give some people to talk about some things. I like when people talk about me. The more you talk about me, the more God start exalting me. Where the people who got some people talking about this? I got some people talking. Let them talk what they want to talk. Let them say what they want to say. The Lord is on your side. I prophesy that everything they talk against, God getting it put in your life. Somebody say double, double, double. So big. When they see you come out this time now, the Lord say, fill powerhouse. 218 is your year of victory. 218 is your year. According to where God is taking you, I wish I could find some celebrators in this house. Says the twin torn between two opinions. Sometimes as a leader, you want to do things that way. And then sometimes as a leader, Bishop Roy was the best. Sometimes as a leader, you will follow God when every leadership go against you. Y'all ain't never been here. Nehemiah find himself in chapter 3 going against leadership. People who should have been on his side. I have discovered that there are some people who stick with you as long as they're good. But when things start getting blurry, when things become looking like you're getting to a storm, they say, I can't stay around here. Let me find a church where they get into a storm. But maybe if the anointing of the hands of the Lord is for your life and that side of God, you will go down to the Baptist church. You will return right back to the powerhouse. Because what you connected to, nobody has pointed on you. That's why I'm so glad that when difficulties come in your life, the Bible says in chapter 4, Nehemiah find himself fighting against those who should have been with him. Let me help you to understand, Apostle. If it was for you, they would have stayed with you. If it was for you, they'd have been in here today. But there was the ones who was against you. I'm so glad that when people turn against the vision, because some people feel like if they leave the church door's gonna shut down. Maybe the devil is a liar.
stood upon this rock, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall prevail. Destroy points of places, because the hands of the Lord, don't you never say neighbor. Ah, Nehemiah, he got vision, and he got action. Oh, the devil in life, then you got vision, and you got action. Because once you got vision, well, vision is, the people can't perish. But when you ain't got no vision, the people dying. The Lord say, don't you dare leave this house. Because when I'm about to put a powerhouse, it's going to be so big. Make sure I never say big, 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 big.
It's too late. So look at chapter 5. Look at chapter 5 for yourself. This is now the oppressors. The people who feel like they can oppress Nehemiah and do what they feel like to Nehemiah. Can I tell some of y'all in this season, God, get ready to move some oppressors out of your life. The thing who got the power to oppress you. God say, I'm getting ready to put some people right in the bottom of your feet. When they think they're in charge of Nassau, Bahamas. When they think they got control everything. God say, this the season. Whoever rises up against you this year, I'm about to screw it before the year comes to end. See, you only want that kind of stuff. Not with that new song, right? Well, that's your business. They were trying to oppress Nehemiah in chapter 5. I said, Nehemiah, we got you right where we want you. But God said, no, Nehemiah. There are some people in Jerusalem who are praying. I wish I could find some people who say, I'm still praying for my forces. Praying the people in their souls who say, I'm still praying. Trust, twitch, and hide your forces. I said, apostle, I got you in this season. I'm your intercessor. I'm interceding on behalf of your life. I don't care what the devil tries. As long as God got some warriors in this place. Let your neighbor say, neighbor, we are not just an overcomer, but we are more than conquerors. We have overcome this before. And if we have beat it before, we are about to beat it again. Let my fighters out of this house. Down in chapter 6 now, and now it happened when Samaritan and Tobias and Gershom and the rest of my enemies. Now let me help you in this season. There are some people who can't come against you by themselves, so they need more ammunition. They need more force. They need more people. So the Bible said, now listen what happened. Now Gershom and the rest of my enemies, they heard. I want you to put your hands on your ears. I said, my enemies, it's about to hear what God get ready to do for me. I don't know what you're believing God for that. But God said, just told your enemies, you are about to make your best move in this season. Checkers. If you know how to play checkers on my garment, the devil think he got you locked in. But the Lord tell me I just made the biggest move in your life. Oh, you only know how to play my garment. You only know how to play checkers. Man, the devil think he got you locked in. Man, he think you got you boxed in. God shall make a way. Man, there is no other way. Is there anybody here? I hear the Lord say, where my friend walkers are here. And Gershom and Arabian and the rest of my enemies heard that I had rebuilt. Oh my God. Lord, will you say?
say it for powerhouse. He said, I will allow what happened to powerhouse for a rebuilding. What do you say? There were some people who want to get consumed in the fire.
There were some people who want to leave under the fire. There were some people who couldn't stay in the midst of the fire. Anybody here so hot in the fire get? Somewhere in the fire that it gets so hot. I tell you, say, now God, what are you doing in this season? The Lord sent me here to tell you, apostle, this your season of rebuilding. But your neighbor said, we are about to rebuild. That means what you had in inflammatory. It's a joke what God can remove to you. Is there anybody here? Listen to what God said, I didn't give you up. God said it's gonna be the season that when they walk into church, in the cathedral, and they say, oh. God said, I'm getting ready to blow their mind. So they just gotta believe it. This is the event that took place. Somebody put a celebration in the atmosphere that is getting ready to happen. Somebody show glory. Says now getting ready to rebuild the walls, and there was no breach left. That you never say ain't gonna be no space. Ain't gonna be no space. When God gets ready to give us, I hear the Lord say, I'm going to put the church in the middle, and all around the church, all I see is business. Oh, y'all ain't hear what I just said. Y'all ain't hear what I just said. There's gonna be trouble. Y'all ain't hear what came first time for power. You are not going to work for a job. You'll be able to go to work. I thought they tell him in the season. But I'm getting ready to tell him in the season. I hear the Lord say, blossom. You are ready for the blossom. And your neighbor says, this thing will be like a bridge. Ain't no space going to be available. Because God said, all the order here are entrepreneurs. We're the leaders in this church. Who are they called to be rich? I was called.
Let me talk to y'all. He said, a time that I have not hanged the doors in the gate. The first thing the Lord said, tell apostle, the next blessing I'm getting ready to give you, hang the doors. Don't leave the walls of your ministry open for the enemy. Preacher, what are you saying? God said to Nehemiah, the time has come that when you hang the doors, that you want to room for those that sneak in unaware. Wow. Don't you know there's some preachers who come in your church pretending they all for you? They celebrating you, but boy, they hate on you. They said, wow, how could this happen? He said, this time when you build this church, break the doors and don't let the enemy creep in. Because there's some people in this Nassau, Bahamas, they think they're gonna take out the teachers. Only God can get them for Jesus. But God sent me to tell some of y'all, I'm getting ready to give your apostle something so big. I heard the word get free. Oh, y'all ain't ready for this. I heard the word get free. But your neighbor say get free. Somebody but your neighbor say neighbor. But we will do it. Hide the doors. And don't let the enemies in here. Is there anybody you're ready to fight the enemies? Stop coming in here. Somebody show glory.
Jesus.
Sit down, let me talk. He said, hang. Watch this. He said, hang the doors. Don't leave the walls of your ministry is open for the enemies.
My God.
You think everybody in Nassau like you?
No, sir.
You got to be crazy. You think everybody in Nassau for you? You got to be fanatic. You got some people who smile in your face and stabbing on your back. I remember when Bishop Roy, they sent a warrant out there. They sent a warrant out there in Nassau Village.
Yes.
We get ready to demolish every
yes.
church. And I remember the year
yes,
that I came down to that church.
God.
And God said that church would not be the one.
Yes.
And the enemy would not come to that dwelling place. God said, this is going to be the season that when
the enemy think they just gonna come upon you. Lord, I'm about to put a shield of protection around you. Is there anybody here? The enemy feel like he got the victory over you. But when Jesus step in the midst of it, somebody say, God the God.
God says, don't leave the walls of your ministry open for the enemy.
Jesus.
Red Flaming Street back to the fire, to the flood,
Jesus,
and to the rivers. Man. There was not there for you.
Hey, glory.
You ever know people can only be your friend as long as you're up? Okay, y'all didn't want to be truthful in here.
Go ahead.
Y'all didn't want to be truthful in here. Hit your neighbor, say neighbor.
Neighbor.
You ain't had them kind of friends in your life, eh?
My God.
There's some people who have come in your life as long as they're good in your life. But if you look at you, they're down. Oh, they start walking away. I can't bother with that now, because he ain't on my level, he ain't on my scale. He ain't on the place where God taking me. I like when you treat me like that. That's the time when God step in and do something that is unusual. God said, God, the ministry to start.
Jesus.
So there's some people, Apostle, who was there then, even with you now.
Amen.
I got some pastor friends, Mr. Roy Boys, who tell me, I'm your friend no longer. I said, hit the road, Jack.
Don't look back.
And don't you come back?
Amen.
No more? So you want to try to find friends, you want to try to buy friends. But a true friend would stick with me in the good, not in the bad. When the apostle called me, I was not the preacher.
Amen.
But because he called.
It's who it was. Holy Ghost.
And when I hear on the next line, I need you.
Jesus.
That means he need a warrior. Y'all ain't saying nothing to me. He said, I just don't need somebody to overcome. I just need you some stuff with the boss of Peterman. Because church folks will hang with you today and drop you tomorrow. Anybody remember when they saw the Jesus? They said, Hosanna, Zion the highest. The next thing they want, what?
Crucify him.
When I heard the call, I said to myself, self,
yes,
we got to go. Well, you say nothing. See, you have to speak to yourself sometimes. I talk to myself, and I said, I got to get my mind together. Because if my brother needs me, I got to get on board of what he's dealing with. And then I heard the topic. I'm not just an overcomer, but I'm the one that's telling the devil that I'm a warrior. See what people that overcome, you still try to battle with. Let your neighbor say, keep them out.
Keep them out.
Come
hang the door.
So. You
got to
hang the door.
Amen.
Glory.
Got it.
Come here, minister. Come here. Come here, prophet. Come here. While he preaches, you hang the door. You don't let any and everybody come up in here. If your hair's back, you're in the wrong house, baby. Because I wasn't saved all my life. I may just toss you down, pick you up and let you out. You'll come up in your plane. If you know you, you don't begin, Lord, I can't wait to stay away from my life. Don't come up with power, homie.
Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Jesus.
The job of the apostles.
Yeah.
Is the establishing work. The job of the ministers is the God the work.
Yes. My God.
See, every now and then.
Come on.
I said, God, give me a pillow. Yeah, give me a piece of anyone who like the cussing and being fully delivered. So when you come to church and you cuss me, I cuss the hell out of you. And then you will tell your pastor on me. I don't care what you feel about me. You don't say what you want to do. But if God be for me, man, I'm here in this place. You say that I was at the enemies. Come and you do what they be like. And I just sit down.
Hey!
God shall send to me saying,
preach.
Come down.
Preach.
Oh
my God. Preach, prophet. Preach. Preach.
Come on. Who's you to judge me to tell me come down?
Amen.
Didn't your text say for the elect? Who's you to tell me I ain't doing what I supposed to be doing? You ever know some people feel like they pastor so holy and you ain't living right? Touch your neighbor and say, please. Be careful how you point with on me. Because the same way you think on me, they draw a knock on you. That's why I don't like when people come around me gossiping. I still kept their head on my face. I don't want to hear nothing. When the Holy Spirit is defeated, that means you don't want me to do it. But there are some people. Watch what the text says. He says, why? They sent to me saying, come down. Let us meet among in the valley of the place of called Ono.
Ono.
Watch your neighbor say Ono.
Ono. No.
Well, let me give you the next word. The second thing I want to tell you, apostle, in this season. Don't assemble yourself with people who just dwelling in the valley, just settle.
Wow.
Well, I'm going to hang with pastors who pay in rent. No, the devil's a liar. I'm hanging with some people in this season who got a church already established. See, the problem with some of us, when you hang with some people who just stuck in a place, just paying rent all their life, they going to tell you, I move from down East Street, I down Robinson Road, from Robinson Road, I down Shirley Street, from Shirley Street, then I back on Robinson Road, baby. God say, this is the season. You want to say, oh no. When we come up from where we at, we don't put the keys on the door. Make the people get away and go to the place. I say, we ain't getting back to that place. You try never say, oh no. God say, get a boss up.
Oh no.
So, do not assemble yourself with people who just want death in the body. Who just said it in a condition of honor?
My God.
That you never say, oh no.
Oh no. Oh no.
I ain't standing here. This isn't where the church is, right? Y'all up here too? Y'all next door? That you never say, neighbor? This is the last year. Boss coming up the step.
That's right.
Oh, where we at?
Yes.
Okay, y'all don't believe me?
Yes.
I prophesy that God will not settle the state where you're at. Better people ready to change their mind. Ready to change the place they like. That means you want to change your way of thinking. Also, we time to come up these steps. Be ready to walk one place. Start to the door. Sit down at the cathedral. And run around. Some of you all feel like running today. But it's too small. Some of you all feel like jumping today. But it's too small. So the Lord shall get ready to give you something. When you feel the fire, you're going to run a tree out. I don't feel tired. Find some people who are going to say this to you, apostle.
My God.
You ready to go pay rent to the next place? Tell them, oh no.
Oh, no.
And you never say, oh no.
Oh, no.
When we come out of this place, we getting our wound. When we go to this place, it's going to be furnished by God. I want a miracle in this season that eyes have not seen, no ears have heard, no into the hearts of man. Somebody hold up, oh no!
Oh, oh no.
Okay, listen what it says. But they taught to do me no mystery. You ever know some people thinking of doing you something wrong?
Yeah.
But they know they mess with you, oh, they finish.
Yeah.
Right. You see the man at the door? You are? And dangerous.
Amen.
You know, just pull up on me.
Not just like that.
Even if they want to do something to you.
Amen.
Then they see you at the door and you ain't got a smile on your face. And you got your hand right there, they can see that thing on the side of your face. Oh, yeah, I got a couple of them. Yeah, God, I say, Lord, restore back. Because I need them right now.